yet. You too, huh? time to wait. How do you like the story so far? once upon a time. And if this evening had not happened, well, then this tale could not be. Well, once there was a man. Naive. He was kind, but certainly, like so many of us, he was poor. And so, as not to be a burden on his people, he went out into the world. Nothing but a small loaf of bread in his pocket and the image of his eyes' delight, his true love in his heart. He went to seek his fortune. He walked the long road. Rode in cold boxcars as they wound their way through valleys on their tracks like rivers. He rode on barges as they wound their way through valleys, on rivers like train tracks. He listened to farmers in their carts. The beets were very sweet this year. Go to the small villages. He would offer to plow the fields. will reach into his pocket, take a piece of bread, eat it. Careful to save the crumbs. He would go to the towns, and he would offer to sweep the streets. But no one would hire him. So, he would reach into his pocket. Careful to save the crumbs. This went on for some time. Then, one late afternoon, as the cold darkness draped its cloak over the hills, the man found himself on an old wagon track. And so, he picked up his legs, one, two, down the track, looking for the light of a farmhouse, or perhaps a fellow traveler. Soon, it was so dark, he had to use his feet to find his way. Until a great constellation of fire was before him. And as he came into the firelight, he heard music. Came down from the stars, dancing in giant circles, leaving valleys for the rivers to wander. And in the golden holiness of a night that will never be seen again, the giants raised up the paper man and made him know their horrible strength and their endless hunger. Well, the man had nothing. He was a poor man, a paper man, as empty as the rails he rode. But he reached into his pocket, took out a slice of bread, his last. When the giants saw the bread, they danced around the man faster and faster, each calling for the bread. A morsel for a man, and nothing but a speck of dust for giants. And the man didn't know what to do. Which giant should he give the bread to? Finally, he flung the bread high above, the figures below. Let them decide. But the bread rose high above, a luminous disc of light that filled them up. A man of crumbs, sisters, brothers, a man of crumbs never wastes a crumb. And the giants laughed. and capered about, and they would have clapped the man on the back if it would not have killed him. And they danced around and around in great circles up into the stars. There was light. There was music. And like a new constellation, they moved across the sky. Until even giants get tired and dizzy. They left him on the hill alone. The man slowly turning under the starlight, his soul filling with the beauty of the world and the promise of breadcrumbs. And under a blanket of stars, the paper man slept and dreamed. Sometimes you sleep, and sometimes you dream. Sometimes you run for the train. Sometimes you catch the train. Sometimes you miss the train. Sometimes you wait with strangers. How are you? Sometimes you tell the stranger stories. What happened to the man? But sometimes you dream, and sometimes you are dreamed. The man dreamt of himself, of giants, bread, of a lost child. And of course, he dreamed of his eyes tonight, his true love. Thank you. Understood his great fortune. his great gift. Always a piece of bread to eat or give, and a story to tell. And so the man listened for train whistles to guide him home to his people. And to his eyes' delight, his true love. He gave bread to anyone who needed it, one piece at a time, especially to the children. And surely, when he gets home, his true love, his eyes' delight, will have waiting for him. Surely. Always save the crumbs. Oh, my train! My train!